Whatever you went through in life, all of your downs are only now is your challenge, your test, not to give up and to believe in Hashem Yitbarach, even though that you messed up, even though that you failed. You failed? Great. It increased the challenge, the difficulty of the test of your mindset to break the limitations and the constrictions and your fears. No, Hashem doesn't love me. But if you're going to get over that imagination and you will decide, I love Hashem and I'm serving Him because I love Him and I know He loves me and I couldn't care less, you will become righteous much faster than you can imagine. Much faster. Because Rachmana Liba Bai, because the Creator, He wants the heart. He's seeking for your purity, for your intention. Where is your will? And if you know that you have that good will, Hashem Yitbarach will give you power to know the future, to clean yourself, to love the rebuke. Challenges of life are rebuking you, showing to you that you're a zero. Sometimes Hashem is so merciful that He puts a speaker in your house that every day is reminding you that you're a zero. It's great. It's great. Because at Asher Yohav Hashem Yochiach. Because God rebukes the one He loves. Et Asher Yohav Hashem Yochiach. So what you should do, you should love the rebuke. How are you going to love the rebuke? You're going to accept it with love. You're going to accept that learning, that education. And not going to be scared. Why are you scared from the rebuke? Because you don't want to feel it. Because you don't want to be humbled. You don't want to be ashamed now. Why? Because your heart is not clean to hear the full message of Hashem. Because you still want honor and you still want quiet and you want to have your time for yourself and you're selfish. So you cannot receive the whole message, Dvar Hashem, the complete words of Hashem to you, that He's using 100% of the world, of the creation, for His purpose, to tell you what His will is, and to show you, and to let you hear, until you can understand it, and receive it completely. And not only from outside. The outside is supposed to wake you up to feel what goes on inside. And I said it many times in my classes. Even if you heard the most fascinated class in your life, you sat in front of that amazing rabbi and his words were so powerful, you don't need to follow his advice right now. What do you need to do? You need to listen to your own heart. What happened to me because of that class? When that rabbi spoke, which point he touched inside of my heart? What I felt when he was talking about tshuva? What was my feeling when he was talking about praying and talking to Hashem, on dedicating my life to serve Hashem? What happened inside of me? Because everyone will take a different message from the class, and that's how it's supposed to be. That you will develop, and that he will develop, and that he will grow, and that he will grow, and that everyone will take one thing that belongs to the point of truth of their heart right now. Because through your heart, through your feeling, you connect yourself to Hashem. Why? Because Hashem made it like that. That the heart is the channel, that through that channel you are wired, connected, you receive the information from heaven, and also you can come back through that same channel. If it's blocked, if it's sealed, you can come back, you can do tshuva, you can come back to Hashem. That's what the Rabbeinu is saying.
It's just a temporary world, that in this world, in this period of time, we have a mission. What's the mission? The mission is only not to forget the Creator, to remember that it's all Him, never to fall in the trap of all of those coverings, of all of those husks.